Welcome to Knowledge for Kids YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn about perimeter, which is the first unit of our grade 10 mathematics syllabus. Perimeter of a plane figure. As you all know, in this table there are four shapes, a rectangle, square, triangle and a circle. You already know how to find the perimeter of these basic shapes from previous grades. We learned about circles to find the perimeter, the circumference, in grade 9 using the 2 pi r formula. Let's start up our lesson by doing the review exercise. Find the perimeter of the following plane figures. See the first Roman number. You should add up all four sides, 20 cm plus 10 cm, again 20 cm. And 10 centimeter. Let me show here 20 centimeter, 10 centimeter. Again, you know that this side is also 20 centimeter, and this is 10, so it's 60 centimeter. The second one is 28. How? See, one side is 7, so this all four sides are equal. So you multiply 7 centimeter into 4, it's 28 centimeter. Third one, you know here this is an equilateral triangle, that's why they have put all these three lines to represent that this is an equilateral triangle. So you multiply 12 cm into the number of sides, so it's 3 sides, 36 cm. This one, fourth one, 12 cm here, 3 cm, 3 cm, 5 cm. How you know that this is 5? Here it's 8 cm. And this is 3 centimeters, so you minus 8 from 3, then you know that this is 5. And then here 9 centimeters. Here 9 centimeters, you subtract 12 from 3. Sorry, 3 from 12. So here it's 9 centimeters, and you add again this 8 centimeters. So the total is 40 centimeters. Okay, this one. We don't properly know what is the length of this and this, but we know that the sum of this and this is 10, because when you see the figure, you know that this plus this equals to 10 centimeter. So, and this is also 10 centimeter. You add these two, so it's 40 centimeter. And the circle, which we should use 2 pi r method. I haven't write it over here. Wait, let me show. So you should use 2 pi r. So you know 2 pi is 22 over 7 into 7 centimeter radius. So you simplify 7 and 7. It's 44 centimeter. Okay, now let's see this figure. In this figure, we know all the sides length except one. You know this is 4 centimeter. All these are mentioned, but this one, this line we don't know. So you know they have given here 3 centimeter and 4 centimeter. You can consider this as a right angle triangle and use the Pythagorean relationship like this and find the length of this side is 5 centimeter. Then I add everything together, I got 30 centimeter as my answer. Okay, we have simply finished the review exercise. Our review exercise is what we have done previously in other grades, so it's easy to do. Let's now move up to our lesson. Sector of a circle. You know a sector of a circle is a part of a circle which is bounded by a pair of radii and the arc. Like this. This part is a sector. The part which I have moved away from the circle is a sector. Even this is a sector. You can name it as the minor sector and the major sector. Arc length. Now we are going to learn how to find the arc length of a circle. Arc length. The circumference of the circle equals to 2 pi r. You know, in grade 9 we studied that the formula to find the circumference of the full circle is 2 pi r. So the arc length, like if they give us any of them, any arc length, I mean, with the, you know, in a circle, the midpoint surrounding is 360 degrees, but if they give like 45 degrees, how to find the arc length of it? So, you know, arc length equals to theta over 360. This symbol represents theta. Its name is theta over 360. Let's see the formula. Therefore, arc length equals theta over 360 degrees into 2 pi r. So you should include the angle in this theta position and 222 over 7 into radius. You know, yeah, we should simplify this. Later we'll get this is half a circle, quarter circle, 3/4, and 3 over 4, and this is theta over 360. So that means we can represent any angle in this position. You all will understand when we do an example. Yeah, I took some questions from exercise 1.1. Let's see this question. So you can see in this, you can identify it that this is a half a circle, a semicircle. So it's 180 degrees. We'll put the formula theta over 360 degrees into 2 pi r. Then the angle of this is 180 degrees. We can position the details given. No? So 180 degrees over 360 into 2 pi means 22 over 7. The radius. Now see, they have given us the diameter. So to find the radius, we should divide the diameter into 2. Because the radius is, a diameter is 2 radius. It's equal to 2 radius. So the radius is 14 centimeter. Now we are simplifying. 180 and 360 is half into 14 and 7. You can simplify. Then this is 2 and this is 1. Then 22 into 2. Wait, let me show you. Theta is 180. Then you simplify 7. Then it's 1. Here 2. Then 2 into, sorry, you simplify this as 1, and here 2, you simplify, then you get half into 2 into 22 into 2. So it, you can simplify this 2 and this 2. Then 22, you should multiply by 2, it's 44 centimeter. I took another question. Let's see how to do this. Theta over 360 into 2 pi r. So they have given us the angle is 240. 2. Radius 35 centimeter. Pi is 22 over 7. Now we simplify. This has 3. This has 1. Sorry. 2. And this is 3. Then 7 and 35 is 5, and that's all. Then we multiply 2 over 3 into 2 into 22 into 5. So when we multiply all these along with the 2 here, we get 440 degrees over 3. So we should, you can even leave your answer as this, but I wrote it as a mixed number and I got the answer 146, 2 over 3. Okay, now we are going to learn how to find the perimeter of a sector of a circle. This is similar to this, but this time the previous villain only to find the Arklen. But in this, we should find a full sector along with this radius and this radius. We should add up everything. So, to find the arc length, we used only this formula. But to find the full sector, we need to add the two radius. This radius and this radius. In addition. I took a question from the exercise. Let's do it. So, you know, I told the formula is theta over 360 into 2 pi r plus 2 r. So you simplify 60 and 360 is 1 over 6. Then 7, 3. Any other to simplify? Okay, at last I got like this, 1 over 6. Still I can simplify, right? I simplified 2 and this is 3. Then again I simplified for the next one, 3 and 3. Then I multiplied, 22 and 2 into 21, I solved it. Then I got 22 plus 42. Then the answer is 64 centimeters. Let's do this question and finish up our lesson. A semicircular portion of diameter 7 cm has been cut out from a semicircular lamina of radius 7 cm and welded to the lamina again as shown in the figure. So the first question we have, find the arc length of the sector of the radius 7 cm. It means sector of the radius 7 cm. It means this one. We should consider this one. Because this is the diameter, this is the radius of this circle, 7 cm radius. So, let's find it, the formula. Theta over 360, 2 pi r. So 180 degrees over 360 degrees, we should put the data. Then 2 into 22 over 7 into radius 7 centimeter. Then we should simplify half, 7 and 7. Then simplify the 2, 22 centimeter. Roman number 2. Find the arc length of the sector of the circle of diameter 7 cm. So, you know, this is the formula theta over 360, 2 pi r. In this, they have to find the arc length of the sector of the circle of diameter 7 cm. We can see this is diameter of this circle. Semicircle is 7 centimeter. So is that the radius? No, it's diameter. So we should take half of it. It's 3.5. Then pi is 22 over 7. And its angle is 180. Half. Yeah, then we should simplify half. Then 7, 2. Because 7 has 2, 3.5, then half into 2 into 22 over 2. We simplify this, 11 and 1, half, again you can simplify this, then you can get 11 centimeters. Now they have told us in the Roman number 3, find the perimeter of the shaded region, this total picture. So I add, we got this length as 22, then this one as 11. See, this one belongs even to this. and this we add 11 and 11 is 44. Okay, we have finished our lesson from here. I hope you all understood everything. Thank you for watching my video. I'll try to do better than this in my next video.